Democracy champions from all over the world descend on New York City for the Obama Foundation's Democracy Forum. Among them, former Philippine Vice President Lenny Robredo. Don Tagala has this story.
Welcome to the Obama Foundation Democracy Forum.
Former U.S. President Barack Obama's foundation hosted an inaugural democracy forum that convened pro-democracy activists and leaders from around the world in one stage, New York City.
Our foundation's mission has been to inspire, empower, and connect the next generation of changemakers. And all of you, most of you in the audience, fall in that category.
The Obama Foundation hopes the Democracy Forum will serve as a platform to share ideas that are vital to keep democracies alive.
These democratic ideas are currently under assault around the world. We see it in the backsliding that's taking place in what were well-established democracies. We see it in the escalating polarization and disinformation that's so evident in recent elections. Whether it's in Brazil, the Philippines, Italy, Sweden, right here in the United States.
The former president underscored that the foundational principles of democracy are under attack.
The notion that all citizens have a right to freely participate in selecting who governs them. The notion that votes will be counted and the party that gets more votes wins. That losers concede, that power is transferred peacefully. That the winners don't abuse the machinery of government to punish losers and entrench themselves and make it impossible for other parties to compete in future elections. Our political debate should at least aspire to be rooted in facts and logic rather than fabrication and propaganda.
During his presidency, he was able to point to the United States as an example of a strong and vibrant democracy in order to encourage other countries to adopt our core principles of democracy, including respect for the rule of law, open and fair elections, smooth and orderly transition of power.
Obama said this gathering brought together some of the remarkable leaders, top thinkers, and practitioners in the field to take a hard look at the trends that place democratic pluralism on the defense, so that global leaders can start developing the tools that would rebuild a stronger democratic culture and a more durable set of democratic institutions for the future. Among those leaders is former Philippine Vice President Lenny Robredo, who was a panelist in the discussion of disinformation and protecting democracy. Robredo said disinformation has already evolved.
It is not just pushing fake news or propaganda, but it has evolved to the point that a separate public sphere has already been created, such that it seems like there are two different, separate, almost incompatible information ecosystems that already destroyed a common baseline of facts, which is very essential for discourse, for discussions, for accountability in a democracy.
The former presidential candidate admitted that although late in the game, bringing her campaign outside of social media made some breakthroughs in fighting disinformation.
We called it tao sa tao, puso sa puso. It means person to person, heart to heart. So it was encouraging our supporters to go out of social media, try to talk to as many people who do not share your values, who do not share your beliefs, you know, and try to discuss in a very calm manner. And we have made a lot of breakthroughs. But as I've said, time was too short. And our campaign now is to continue those conversations.
Robredo says to unmask the disinformation operations in the Philippines through groundbreaking research and learn from these lessons is just one way to protect and defend democracy and even move forward with a stronger one. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.